Hello, everyone. I think we're a little early. I don't know. But I thought I'd kick off. I've been waiting here for the clock to strike over. It's like wasting your life away. Terrible. Anyway, welcome to episode 8 of Kano Mint Streams. And this week, it is Bangai-O by Treasure Software. Released in 1999 in Japan and North America and 2000 in Europe. We're playing the European version, the PAL version, on the Dreamcast. There was an N64 version released in Japan only. I never played that one. I've only ever played this and the DS game. Not streaming a DS game. I might do that one day when I actually get one converted to allow me to stream from it. But for now, you're going to have to wait. I am playing this on European Dreamcast. Hang on. Just going to do some jaking of something. Let's have a look. Yep. Yeah, we're good. Okay. This is... this is Bangai-O. Bangai-O! Exclamation point. And it's about a big robot and a pair of teenagers controlling it after their dad built it. There's a story to this game. It doesn't really matter, though. I am playing it on my Dreamcast, as I said, and here is the controller, the infamous Dreamcast controller. There it is. It needs a bit of a clean. I did clean it once recently, but I don't know. Anyway, if you noticed, there's the little VMU inside. You can see the little screen there. I've got it up and running, and using 2032 batteries, which I'll have to take out immediately after playing this, because it really sucks those batteries dry. Interesting control method. It's actually a twin stick shooter. Technically, it's a twin stick shooter, but there's no twin sticks. This game is also available on the Xbox 360, I believe, on Xbox Live Arcade. Not sure if you can still get it, though, because, as we all know, technically the Xbox 360 is now a retro machine, of all things. Can't really figure that out, but we now know the PS2's retro machine, because definitely PS2, because it's like almost 20 years old. So apparently now 360 is, because no one's making it anymore. So that's the rule. Anyway, getting digressed. So how does this game work? Well, you'll see. I'll just go through with it rather than just sort of sitting and talking about it. So it's a twin stick shooter with two D-pads rather than two sticks, because the Dreamcast controller, as wonderful as it is, only has one thumbstick. Now the thumbstick does work in this game, but it doesn't really do anything really useful. This fires in all directions. Don't know why. It's rubbish, really. So, and forgive the sound coming out from the Dreamcast. You might be picking up on the mic. It's just a 20-year-old machine. I mean, it's my original Dreamcast that I bought in 1999. So, sorry. It's a miracle it's still working, really, isn't it? It's got a game options, so I thought I'd show you this. So there's different, you can play music. The music on this game, this version, the Dreamcast version, is beautiful CD quality, whereas on the N64, apparently, it's all sampled sound, so it's a bit muddier. So they did that, and that's why they're sort of celebrating, oh, look, you can play all the music, and it is really good tunes. In fact, I'm surprised, I'd be very surprised if some of these tunes were not featured on Sound of Play. And Sound of Play, if you don't know, is a podcast that we at Kano Mint release every Wednesday. It's one of my highlights, actually. I really love listening to Sound of Play. When it drops, I immediately start listening to it, because it's very relaxing. And I listen to that before another show. I won't mention the other show. Anyway, there's two different control methods. There's XB, XY, we do twin stick. And then there's this method. No! This is default. And you can only shoot in the direction you're traveling in. What? No, that's not. So this is more a traditional way of controlling it. I assume that you much prefer to do this. But this is 2019, not 2000. People know twin stick shooters now. We're all right. We're okay with them. So, and then we have replay mode off, sound stereo. I've got stereo here. You can hear it out there in the internet. So I'm not going to change anything. I've been playing this a little bit today. Not much. I mean, you know, doing all sorts. I've been playing a bit of VR today, actually. First time for a while. Tetris. Tetris game. Is it? What's its name now? Anyway. So let's just start the game. My initials. There we are. C-O-R. As you can see, Chris O'Regan. And, yes, let's just start the game. So, I've done level 1, done level 2, and I can go to level 3 if I so choose. There's 44 levels in all. How many are we going to get through tonight? I don't know. But we shall see. It gets trickier and trickier, and each level is actually more like a puzzle than it is anything. And you'll see how this works, and it's a peculiar game, but this is Treasure. And they've made some peculiar games over the years, and this game is actually quite well venerated, so let's go for it. So, Burning Star of Dance. So if I switch over to or I can switch over to this fellow here. He fires off missiles. They have names, it doesn't matter. Now the idea is you have to see the number at the top middle there. I'm trying to get as many explosions as I can, because the more explosions I have, the more I'm rewarded for it, because this game is all about explosions, believe it or not. And the more explosions you have, the more sort of... So these are enemy robots that... there's lots of them, oh my goodness. So yes. Oh look, they're dropping out of this thing. I'm going to do a super shot. It's a bit overkill for these, but they do blow up a lot of things, and you get rewarded for blowing up lots of things. So it really is a point chaser. This game is ultimately a point chaser. It's a single player experience, though, oddly enough. But I suppose you're trying to beat a high score of your friends if you have like multiple people playing the same game. But yeah. Feels, look, there's no real vibration on the floor. I think it might be an earlier Dreamcast game, I don't know. But you'd think there'd be lots of vibrations going on. Maybe not, I don't know. But it is a pure twig stick shooter. And the idea is that the more threat you are under, the more explosions you generate. It's a bit strange. But I've blown up that thing there. I must confess, I did read up some guides and read the manual. It's a thing we always do on this show, always read the manual. And it's a bit rubbish, actually. Didn't really talk about the different control modes. I've got to say, it's a bit rubbish for that. So you just have to figure it out yourself. But, yeah. So these missile launch fellow, this one, this mode of fire, is generally preferred in open areas like this. And I'll show you the other mode. Well, I did show you the other mode a little bit. But, all of the explosions, all of them! Go through this door. Now I know the boss is here, very close by. I'm not going to deal with him yet. I don't know why these things have... There we are. There he is. Aha, you stop at speed or just very small. The boss at the station. The boss or maybe... I'm Street Urchin Sabu, I've been waiting for you. Feel this. Okay. Yeah, so I'm gonna. So, the... Oh, that took him out pretty easily. It's the first level. It's teaching you how to play the game. That's fine. There's a bit of, like, mech sort of like Gundam stuff. Strange robot punching Godzilla in the face. There's a humour to this game. You haven't figured that already? Fine. Got a bit... Yeah, that's a good old score from me, I've got to say. But, yeah. So this level's teaching you a little bit about what the other character can do. I think it's Ricky and Mimi. Yeah. Oh, I just spotted something. I'm going to do this now. Depending on when you press left trigger, I don't know if you see this. I don't think you can see this. I don't know. It changes the character, the portrait. That's really cool. Anyway, let's do this. So I've got the thumbstick. See, if you use a thumbstick, it just sort of blows everything up. It's rubbish. I'm going to jump on this, and now I've got this one. Today's invitation is Miracle Lucky Time for Super Sexy M. Now it's time we get something secret shooting. So it's Ricky, homing spheres and pursuing... Mammy! That's her name, not Mimi. Mammy. So it's Ricky and Mammy. It doesn't really matter, but yeah. So, here we go. So the idea of what he's trying to do is teach. How, in confined spaces, Mammy's weapon, the laser weapon, is... Well, I call it a laser weapon, it's actually... tracer bullets, but it looks like lasers, but so I'm gonna go with that. But they're not guided in any way, they're just sort of, but they are quite destructive. And the more, you know, get more fruit points, they make prizes, everyone. Gotta be careful here because these laser things need to be destroyed. Go. Whoa! What's that about? Down there? No, I can't. Okay, here we go. So I'll change weapon again because I'm in a nice open area. Yeah, this level is just basically trying to teach me the ropes and how it all works. Whoa! Ow, ow, ow! The plan. Oh. So the boss is going to reappear. It's the same dude! Very strange! How are you still alive? He doesn't know. Ow! That's game over. There he goes. Treasure just didn't care with this game, did they? It just went all out. So I'll try again. I should be more careful. So I'm focusing on explaining how the game works, and I think you can figure it out yourself. So let's just do the thing, shall we? Let's stop messing around. So I don't need to do that again. There you go. explosions, all of them. Ow. Odd that you don't get health from all this fruit. And why are you picking up bits of fruit? None of this is explained. It just happens, you just gotta accept it. Why fruit? Why fruit? Is it trying to send a message to kids or something? Eat fruit? I mean, I'm all for that, that's good. There you go. I'm going to change the weapons, change the missiles. All the explosions. More points. More points! In PVC, I sort of exposed myself to Steady. It's a family show. Unnecessary. Oh, here's the boss again. But I do a better job this time. I'll do a better job. I'm gonna stay at the bottom here. It doesn't seem to be shooting me from... Just keep on shooting him. There you go. Yeah, that's what I did last time. Just stay there and shoot him in the face. There you go. Not the greatest. 39 explosions. So, yeah, games, explosions. Bangai-O! I haven't done level 3. This is new to me and you. Maybe watching this. Maybe I've seen this before. I don't know. Too many unknowns. Oh, there's a information thing again. So as the little blue bar goes up in the bottom left-hand corner there, the more it goes up, the more energy I can actually shoot off with the missiles, you see? I'm not going to go through the door quite yet. All the explosions, all the missiles. There is a timer at the bottom of the screen there, have you noticed that? I'm not sure what happens when it runs out. It's yet to happen to me. Yeah. all the explosions. I need some energy because I'm doing not doing too great. Him again! It's you again! Yes, it is! Same fellow! Seems to be the best way to kill this boss. Doesn't strike me as the most efficient, but it seems to work. You just stand there and shoot him in the face. There you go, he's dead again. Just judge me all you like, but it seems to work. Punch him in the face. Yeah, we're all good. Right! Level 4, I don't know what it's like. Just go, just keep going and going. There's another 40 of these, apparently. Just pure arcade game. What this about? What is this about? Go through here or not? No, it doesn't look like it. Whoa! There you go. That was awesome. That just felt so good. Teddy bear thing. Interesting. Not sure if that was a secret sort of Care Bear bit. I don't know. We don't care. It just happened. I think I found a secret bit. That's cool. Yeah! It's him again. What are we going to do now? Seems to work last time. Just keep shooting. Feels like I'm cheating. But it does the job. And he's down. Again. I punched him in the face again. Of course it's a record, I've never done it before. I like the explosion level, that was good, I enjoyed that. Just keep going, just muscle through this. Right, let's see what information we can glean this level. So the reason I'm not talking at the moment is Stacey is explaining, but already knew, the more threat you're under, the more missiles and stuff that's coming your way, the more counter missiles you unleash. Doing it terribly well this time. But I hit the thumbstick again. It's like a kind of default thing to do, isn't it? Why would you use the D-pad? But you do have to. Yeah, I'm not doing very well. I need some more energy somewhere. Sure, I'll pick up some energy somewhere. Yeah, I'm not doing terribly well. A little bit of energy there, but not much. Who's this? This is all just... Very strange game. Okay, just carry on. More punching in the face of Godzilla. Let's keep going. Care. that's a good example of how the counter missiles work that I talked about earlier. So the more missiles heading your way, the more dangerous it becomes. But you also be able to launch more counter missiles. So you get more explosions, if we get more points. Yeah, kabloom! That's not good. What is this? Yeah, I hit continue, apparently it's a bad thing. Getting hit a lot. I don't know why. I'm gonna die again. It's nasty. That was really nasty. Yeah, we'll carry on. Stupid cartoon thing. Don't know what's going on with this devil. I might try a different weapon. This thing is producing a lot of blue robots, which are pretty horrible. There's some energy through there. Ow. That's nice. The hell is this? I don't. Ow, this is not good. Ow! Yeah, I'm not in a good way. I changed weapons, that was a bad call. It's hurting my hand though. This control method is... it hurts. I was gonna say it. We're gonna carry on. I don't know what that cartoon's about. Don't care. Yeah. hell? I know the boss is just around here, he's just up there. So. Just gonna get rid of the turrets. Some more energy. Because they cause a lot of problems when I played this boss last time. So if I just clear the area. It's not an unreasonable thing to do. There we go. There he is again. So, yeah, tactic, bit of strategy, why not? Oh, that was stupid. Need some more energy now. If there's any around here. No, I went straight through him. Oh well, just gonna have to do this the hard way then. No, I'm not gonna do this the hard way then. So I saw that bit of energy near where the boss was. Right, I can do this. Do this. I believe in me, I can do the thing. One thing I've found out about these streams is I get better at these games. But level 6? Being scuppered on level 6? Dear me. It's embarrassing. Oh. Oh no, not down here, not down here. No, 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 no. That was horrible down there. Do what I did last time. No! Too early! I see some energy down in the bottom right-hand corner there, so I'll need it now because I'm pretty screwed up there. Those ones when it does that. Ow, 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 ow. Come on, you can do this. I'll do this. I think I died at the same time it died. Have you noticed that? I think I just survived. Whoa. Okay. It's getting hot. It hurts the thumbs. It's not sympathetic to ones. Yeah, it hurts. I actually asked a question for some people, like, you know, is this better with the arcade pad? Because I do have the arcade pad for the Dreamcast. And they said, no, doesn't really work with that very well. And they're right, it doesn't, because the layout of the things don't work. So yeah, oh well, I did ask, because a lot of shooters, side-scrolling, uppy-downy or left and righty shooters, work really, really well with an arcade stick. So. Yeah. interesting. See, so some weapons can pass through some walls and others can't. Okay, that's really interesting. This is not good. Yep, I'm gonna blow up. I'm about to blow up. Well aware of my potential of blowing up right now. Well, I need some energy. There you go. You do well to laugh at me like that. I think I just spotted some energy there as well. It's not fair. Not fair. Keep going. We can do this. Level 6. We can beat. Oh, level 7 actually. And 7, done 6. We witnessed these 6 being completed. So yeah. Nibbling away at my energy. It's not good. Points I don't want. Energy I do. Definitely rewards. Points for explosions. Oh, got the energy pack. How did that, but I did. Shoot through the green stuff, obviously. Got his boss again. It's a bit strange one, it just sits there. I do like that at the end. But yeah, there you go. 7 done. 44. Don't think we're going to see level 44 in this stream. Sorry, everyone. Sorry to disappoint. We should continue. Level 8. Here we go. I do prefer this weapon. However, I do like the home missiles as well. And the kind of explosions they produce is pretty cool. Alright, let's get some more information from this very irritating woman. Thing. No, that's where I came from. Oh, there it is. All those points, they made prizes. Look at them all. Look at all the numbers. All the numbers. I wonder why I couldn't fire off my weapon. I'm getting better. I am getting better at this. But I say that and then I make a complete hash of it. It's definitely a case of, oh, wait till things fire and then unleash your hell. It's very strange. Oh well. She's not saying anything, she's drawn a little picture with horses in it. It's very strange. And as she's drawn like happy families, I like the dog. I like the dog. I'm gonna name him Benji. Enjoying that. Let's continue. Skipping through the forest naked, apparently. Bit dodgy. Okay. It's a family show, isn't it? Oh, come on. Oh, there we go. What's the thing? There you go. Get it. Blow up, blow up, blow up, blow up. Let's go again. All the points, all the explosions. Blow it up. There you go. Ow, ow, ow. We shall persevere. What that's about? What is that about? What is any of this about? This game's very strange. What's all that sounds about? No! Stop shooting at me, it's most unfair. Yeah, I'm not. What? Oh. Yeah, this is it really does hurt. That's the hands. This game. Let's carry on. Skipping through the forest again. Not sure what that's about. I'm gonna change weapons. Sod it. I'm gonna change weapons. See what happens. Theory should be worse, but it's not. Yeah, I seem to be doing a lot better with these weapons. Yeah. That'll learn me. There's the boss. Let's do the boss. This time, no missiles, just bullets. It seems to be better. Ooh, 5 minutes. Oh, I've got 4 minutes left. Before the stream ends. Oh, fishes. Hmm. to the thumb pad again. Doing that. Damn! I'm gonna call it there. No, I want my mummy. We'll get them next time. We will! We will get them next time. So yeah, that was Bangai-O on the Dreamcast. The PAL Dreamcast, doesn't matter, because Dreamcast could run at 50Hz and 60Hz. And this is running at 60Hz, in case you didn't see that. I did switch it over to 60Hz, so don't worry. It's all good. So, thank you very much for watching. We will be back next time with Captain Toad's Treasure Tracker on the Switch. It's the first Switch game we've streamed, actually, so that'll be fun. But until then, thank you very, very, very much for watching. And like I said, we'll be back next week with Captain Toad's Treasure Tracker, which is actually linked to Kane and Rince, because Kane and Rince is actually featured in that title in a couple of weeks. So kind of, you know, some symbiosis there. Sometimes with this stream with Kane and Rince, the podcast, which is out every Monday, by the way. Sometimes it's a crossover, like the Ghouls and Ghosts, which I actually streamed last week. That's actually coming up very soon as a Kane and Rince episode. So until then, sorry, my phone went off. Until then, thank you very, very much for watching, and we'll be back next time. Bye!